You're talking with Cliff Schechter, WEAC Radio's own. Cliff, there were some interesting political developments, and I want to tap your political strategic experience in this one. So Liz Cheney, the daughter of former Vice President Dick Cheney, who she served in the State Department, she's decided she has moved her residency back to Wyoming and is considering a run against the sitting Republican senator in Wyoming for the Senate seat that's coming up. This has the potential of greatly dividing the Republican Party. What do you make of Liz Cheney possibly running for Senate and essentially not showing much respect at all to a sitting Republican senator who, at least according to voters there, have served them quite ably?
I think it's awesome. I encourage Liz Cheney to go and sow more dissension, to open her mouth even more and say more things about how torture is wonderful and justify the war crimes of her father, which she likes to do. In the end, all this is going to do is divide the Republican Party, like Christine O'Donnell and Mike Castle divide the Republican Party, like Murdoch in Indiana and Dick Lugar divide the Republican Party. You know, if they want to have her, I assume Enzi is very conservative, but he's not sort of a loudmouth like she is. I assume she'll run more of a right-wing, loudmouth, Palin-esque campaign and talk about Obama as a traitor and all sorts of other things. And she may win in Wyoming because it's such a conservative state, but that sure as hell will really push forward that rebranding effort the Republican Party is trying to do, where they figure they'd like to appeal to more than 2 women and 3 African Americans in the entire country. So if she wants to do it, God bless her. I think she should go forth and prosper, Liz.
And perhaps, Cliff, you and I should give our priestly blessings and encouragement to Sarah Palin, who apparently is also considering a Senate run up in Alaska.
Yeah, I wish I believed that. You know, she's got a book coming out. She needs a little free press from something. Can you imagine her going and giving up all of her meal tickets, the easy speeches in front of Tea Party people who've bilked people of money, and give it to Sarah Palin to get up and wink and make lame jokes? I don't see her. The whole thing has been about the gravy train for her the entire time, so I don't see her doing it. But, man, I'd love it if she would, too. I mean, if these very people we're talking about, the ones that further discredit the Republican Party, and not after the week we've had with them trying to kill immigration reform, with the attacks on women in all states around the country, I don't know if they need much more. But, let them keep doing it. We're watching literally the first time in our lifetime, this happened a lot in the 19th century, we're watching the disintegration of a modern political party. It's rather amazing.
It is amazing indeed. And Cliff Schechter, it is always great and amazing to talk to you. Thanks for being part of the program as always. And Cliff, have a great weekend, my friend.
You too, buddy. Give that little girl a kiss for me and have a great weekend, man.
Sure will. We're going to set up a play date, Cliff, with your kids and our daughter soon enough. Cliff Schechter from WEAC Radio. And folks, coming up next hour, Daniel Marins will take you through the next hour. And again, must hear segments on Bangladesh. This is award-winning work you're hearing on WEAC Radio about the connections between the atrocities, the labor, ridiculous labor standards in Bangladesh, and things that are happening here in the United States with companies like Walmart and The Gap. You got to stick around for this. We're going to take a break, though. Daniel Marins at the top of the hour. You're listening and watching to Take Action News on WEAC Radio.